Hi, my name is Ty Danae Bradley. I'm a mathematician here at SandboxAQ. I've been here for about 2.5 years, and I'm very excited to have our founder and CEO, Jack Hittery, with us today. Jack, thank you so much for joining. In addition to all of these technologies Sandbox is working on, we also highly value education and have close ties with academia. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
No, great question. SandboxAQ is very much tied to the world of academia. We work with more than 40 different universities around the world, and we're always adding additional university partners. If there's any university watching this today that we're not yet partnering with, please reach out to Ty Danae or myself, and we're happy to add that to our partnership list. But what do we do with universities? First off, we believe that companies, along with universities, have a responsibility to train the next generation of researchers and engineers. And AQ technology is so fundamentally important that we're working to train this next generation of individuals so they'll be ready to take on the challenges of the future. Specifically, we have our residency program. Our residency program, which is how we got to know you, Ty Danae. Initially, you came for a postdoc residency with us after you finished your PhD, and then you converted over to joining us full-time as a research scientist. But in addition to yourself, we've now trained hundreds of individuals alongside universities. How does this work? When someone's getting their master's degree, their PhD or postdoc, during that period of time, they can take 3 months, 6 months, sometimes even up to a year, and spend that time with us on a very advanced project, often leading to a paper. We've had two papers in Nature. We've had a paper now in PNAS. Very well-respected peer-reviewed journals that showcase this kind of research. And so we're co-training the PhD students and other grad students alongside our university partners, giving them access to industry-level information and training in advanced coding, in AI, in quantum, in many other different sciences that they may not get in a more siloed PhD program. And the programs themselves have been very enthusiastic, and the response has been great. We're getting more and more students into this. And right now, we have a wonderful cohort of PhD students as we speak at SandboxAQ, joining us around the world. I should mention, it's not just in the US, this is a global effort. We've been training PhD students all around the world with many, many university partners, including Oxford and Cambridge and Imperial in the UK, including the Max Planck Institute in Germany, ETH and EPFL in Switzerland, many other universities in Europe, and of course here in the US with MIT, Harvard, Stanford, Berkeley, Caltech, many, many wonderful universities that we're also now adding to the mix. And so this has been a great partnership with universities that leads to wonderful training of the next generation of individuals for science and for engineering in AQ, but also leads to great output of research. And we believe that industry, alongside academia, can publish world-class research. And many other companies have shown that. Google has shown that, Amazon, Microsoft, and many other big tech companies. And now companies like ourselves can take a cue from that and do the same.
So when discussing the residency program, we spoke about PhD students, but what about folks pursuing other degrees?
No, it's a great question. And initially it's true, we focused mainly on PhD students. PhD students, particularly in physics, neuroscience, mathematics, chemistry, and biology. But now we've expanded this program to include, for example, medical doctors. More and more of the progressive medical schools are encouraging their students to spend some time in industry, particularly industries that will impact the medical world so deeply. We're also now have expanded to business school students. And so we just received our first cohort of MBA students now doing residency with us. They're doing a great job, and they're working side by side with the PhDs to assess what the market impact will be of these technologies. In addition to MDs and MBAs, we're now also expanding our program to policy students. People getting master's degrees usually in policy or international affairs, these kinds of areas, because there's a lot of implications, geopolitical implications and policy implications on a national level for what will happen with AQ technology. One of the areas that concerns us greatly is the quantum divide. We had the digital divide about 20 years ago, the divide between those countries and regions that had easy access to broadband and great bandwidth and those countries that did not. And we now, over the past 20 years, have successfully, finally, been closing that gap, thanks in large part to mobile phone technology. But now we're facing yet another divide, the quantum divide. And the quantum divide is a set of countries, such as the UK, the US, and others, who are at the forefront of quantum technology, and those countries who have not yet invested deeply in quantum technology. And this will have, unfortunately, major implications for those societies if we don't help them to join in on the quantum and the AQ revolution. And so that's an area where policy students can really have a major contribution. And we want to help co-train these policy students in AQ concepts so they can go out and be part of the solution to the quantum divide.
Yeah, incredible.